Hi, welcome to another Power Blast podcast. Hey everyone, Perry Tinsley here, creator of the Power Blast podcast, owner of PutYourselfFirst.com, and founder of Team Power Blast, and author of My Fit Start, the ebook at MyFitStart.com. And just walking through the neighborhood here, I had to get out of the house and just walk around. It's so gorgeous out here. So wanted to give you kind of the results of a one question survey that I did just a few weeks ago. And it was pretty amazing because I had like five questions, you know, what people would want more training on. And one thing that it kind of surprised me, because the thing that I thought was gonna be number one was actually the last one. The things that I asked about was, you know, how to exercise and get fit, be fit and healthy, and when you have a crazy busy life, how to exercise more consistently, you know, be consistent with exercise, how to eat healthy out at restaurants, and another one was late night snacks. What are some good healthy late night snack ideas, and how to get started with exercise. And you wouldn't believe what the top one that I thought was going to be the one that I thought, man, people are going to want to know this, is how to get started with exercise. And that wasn't the case. Obviously, people seem to know. I mean, there was a handful of people, but you know, people seem to know what it takes to actually get started and get going. The part that people struggle with most was the consistency. There was actually two that were tied for number one. How to exercise more consistently. And, take a look. Nobody at the pool. Pretty cool. How to exercise more consistently. And how to stay healthy and fit when you have a crazy busy life. Well, I'll tell you what, I've got you covered on all of those topics, to tell you the truth. And I'm pretty excited. I mean, I'm working on some great content for those people that have those crazy busy lives and are in need to put themselves first and to just to be able to make it happen and be more consistent. I think we can bundle all those together. The part that I want to talk to today, and I've actually created a couple things for you. I created something where you can I've got some tips on how to eat healthy at restaurants, and I'm going to share a couple of those with you today. And then some healthy late night snacks. I bundled some great ideas for you for there to take advantage of that way too. So let's talk about just some tips on things, what I do to eat healthy out at restaurants. I mean, because you've been busting your butt and you're working hard on getting healthy, getting fit, you're following 21 day fix, or it might be a little bit breezy there for you, sorry. 21 day fix you're following, or you're following some sort of eating plan, maybe it's P90X, P90X3. And then people want to ask you out for drinks or for you know, just going out to dinner and stuff like that. And a lot of times people freak on that. They're like, oh my gosh, all my hard work's gonna come unraveled. And you know, it doesn't have to be that way. And you can still have a great time out. Here's what I do. I go in, and if I've got the opportunity, I will go online and look to see if I know the restaurant we're going to. So yeah, a lot of times people just make it up on as we go. But a lot of times I will just go online and see what they've got. And then I'll make the decisions that way. It gives me a little bit of time. But if I'm at a restaurant, I will scan the menu of all the different things that they have to offer. And I will, you know, identify the things that are baked or broiled or you know, made that don't look fattening, that are filled with, that aren't filled with sauces or oils or deep fried, stuff like that. I'll avoid those things. But you know, it's like baked or grilled chicken, right? I mean, that's pretty easy, or salmon. And then I will talk to the waiter and say, you know what? I see this. I see you've got the chicken here, and I really, really like that. But can you combine that? Can I grab the vegetable, the steamed vegetables from over on this menu here? You know, this item, they've got them bundled in certain ways, Like they'll have a steak and you get, you know, this potato and you get all these other other sides. Well, I take a look at the sides that they have on certain things and I'll combine. I'm like, can I kind of customize my own thing? I do the same thing with salads. Salads is a big popular thing because a lot of restaurants will have salads, but they make them big time calorie. They make you think you're getting something healthy, but you know, you'll rack up 1,000 calories real quick with all the things that they put in it. So I'll look at the different salad variations and, well, I said, can I customize my own salad? And they're more than likely willing to do an adjustment. Probably the biggest challenge I've had is like airport restaurants aren't nearly as accommodating, but some are. But that's what I will do, is I will look at those things and those items and I will just question. And a lot of times, you know, the wait staff, they'll go, you know what, let me go and ask the chef if they could do that. And more times than not, they've always been able to do that. Make sure you tip well. If they served you well, you tip well, because they customized it for you to eat healthy and fit. So here's the other thing that you can do. I've got a lot more tips and I've got some great things that breaks down, you know, if you're going to a Mexican restaurant or Japanese restaurant, or if you're going to, you know, maybe a steakhouse, whatever. If you go to mastermymenu.com and you can download my free guide on doing that, just some things I've brainstormed, came up with, and it probably could be developed even more, could have added fast foods or anything, but this covers restaurants when you're going out to eat, just how to master any menu. So mastermymenu.com, you can download it for free. It's all yours, and a lot of the tips that I just gave you are in there, and just enjoy. And I hope that you have a great time. The best thing is, when you're going out there, don't freak about it. Have a great time. You know that you can just get back in and get your workouts in and double up. But there's even tips on there on what to do when it comes dessert time, because you know, people gotta have their dessert, even though they're sitting there in pain from all the food that they ate. So anyway, that's all I have for you this week. I so appreciate you subscribing. Thanks for taking a trip with me and getting me outdoors here in the sunlight there. Hope you have a great one. Thanks for subscribing. Thanks for going over to the iTunes store, giving a 5-star rating so this can be shared with a lot more people. And I appreciate you sharing and commenting below. Maybe you have some tips that I could add to it. I don't know. Anyway, remember, it's never too late. We'll see you next week.